feel defensive about loving a man or even expressing feelings, whether it's of sex or love, and especially shaadi ke baad, you know, God forbid. And another thing I've also noticed, this is a very interesting dichotomy if you realize, guys, ki jab bhi aadmi ka affair hota hai, kisi picture mein, very often it's used in a comedic fashion. You know, like you see movies like No Entry, they use it in a comic fashion, almost as if to, in a some way, justified, or it's very fun, or ek badmashi kahi jaati hai. But till today, I've never seen a comic film where a woman is having an affair. You know, it'll always be considered very serious, very grim, very intense. So that's a very interesting dichotomy I've seen, that, you know, because we still consider it almost like, my God, kaise kar diya, you know, kaise, how can she even think of doing something? We take it in a very serious, but jab aadmi karta hai, it's considered to be ek badmashi hai, something is part of who he is. So tell me, do you believe that we still are very apologetic about a woman's sexual needs?
And, we have to address centuries of history and centuries of culture for that, to really genuinely answer that in a deep way. But of course, I mean, obviously, woman would be considered amoral or without morals if she would fall in love, no matter if she hadn't seen, like in this case, she hadn't seen the husband for years,
yeah.
right after marriage. And in this, it's very tragic because almost everything around her, her environment, her culture, her religion, everything makes her feel like she's doing something sinful.
Right.
So she feels terribly guilty and that she's doing something wrong, and so she, and that in the end she pays the price for that, which is that she loses the guy and he's heartbroken as well. So
yeah.
So in the end, no one really is happy because
but you didn't
one
want
has to live with the lie.
So you didn't feel it would have made it more brave to show an ending where she gets the guy? Because again, that's very rare that it happens in Hindi films where the woman just goes off and, you know, marries the guy. Like even a movie like Murder, for example, which was path-breaking apne zamane mein for all its titillating content, but it was still path-breaking in many ways. Then again, the man turned out to be a scoundrel and eventually she came back to the, you know, comfort of her husband. So, do you believe that it may have, did you ever think of the idea of changing the ending to, for example, that she gets to be with a guy?
Actually, that would have just been untrue. It may have been something aspirational in a sense that she deserves to be happy,
yeah.
But it just would not have been true. So I
but
think
you don't feel that like inspiration is necessary because you see, ye kar sakte hai, toh main bhi kar sakte. Because there are so many women in our country who are in loveless marriages or in
yeah.
unromantic marriages, and they find that sukoon unko kahin aur milta hai, and they would want to, you know. What you're saying is right. I mean,
yeah.
From a realism perspective, this is spot on. You know, what you have shown. Tell me about that. So you
so
feel...
No, so no. I never ever thought that she should be with him because it would just feel sort of in a fantasy way or maybe filmy, honestly.
Yeah.
You know, to stick to the truth and to stick to somebody sort of, this is possibly what would happen in real life. And so at least even at that time in 1997, 20 years ago, maybe even now. So I just wanted to be authentic to the story and to the character.
Yeah.
I mean, it just would suddenly feel like she possibly had the impulse, but she just couldn't go through.
Do you know anybody, without mentioning names of course, in your personal life over the years who has been in a similar situation? And I would like to know what happened eventually. Did she leave her?
Not for me to talk about. No, I don't know. I mean, I do know, but I obviously don't want to talk about it because people's lives are their lives.
No, without mentioning names, I mean, in the sense that do
no,
you know?
So there's all kinds. There
yeah.
will be people who, it's easier in Mumbai, I think,
yeah.
Than in smaller towns.
Yeah.
So I think that some would and some wouldn't. It's finally, you know, it's very easy to stand out and pronounce judgment. It really has to be what is okay for that person.
And if you were in her place, what would you
do?
If you were in her place, what would you have done?
No, it's too hypothetical and it's none of your business. So yeah, no, but it's, I mean, what does that even mean? It, everybody's lives are specifically their own lives, and so it would be such a superior thing of me to say, had I been in her place, you know, I'm not in her place, and I cannot presume to be, you know, in that
situation.
No,
but very often, no, why I'm asking is because it has happened. For example, I have had a very, very dear friend who has been in that place. So let me put it in a different way. If I was in her friend's place, for example, I would have definitely told her that this is your one life that you have, and that you must make an attempt at least to be happy.
Yeah,
you know,
but
I
you
think
know,
I mean,
it's a very, your environment is too strong pressure on you. So it's easy for you to say, of course, having spoken like a man, it's easy for you to say that that you should leave him. She couldn't leave him, the friend couldn't leave her husband. How could she possibly give that advice to another woman? In fact, she said that it'll all be okay, which is the sad thing that everybody resorts to.
But then what ends up happening is, I know I'm starting this debate, but I also feel that we have that one life to live, and we can all wallow in our sadness and say ki hum nahi kar sakte. But I also know of lots of gutsy women who have gotten out of, example, an abusive relationship, which is again very tough to do.
Yeah.
But there are women who do that. So
yeah.
We cannot even say that it is not realistic, because there are lots of women who fight it out also, you know.
Sure, no, it's realistic for this particular story.
Yeah.
In this story, she chooses not to,
okay.
Much to her own heartbreak. So it's not as if she decides to stay home and is happy. She's not. She's really sad, and so is he. So it's not like, it's too easy for us to stand and say, why didn't she do the gutsy thing? You can't hear what people should do in a certain situation. And I think that in this story they didn't. Maybe in other stories they would. So it depends. It just depends.